Isang masayang pagbati na may ngiti sa aking mga labi. Naghahanap ba kayo ng makakatuwang sa pag-review ng inyong anak? Meron yan sa DepEd. Ang ETUlay online tutorial ay libre at handog ng ating kagawaran sa pangunguna ng OUA-ICTS EdTech. Ito ay isang proyektong makatutulong sa mga mag-aaral, katuwang ang mga magulang o kasama sa kani-kanilang tahanan para masagutan at maunawaan ang mga modules. Hangad din ng programang ETUlay ang matulungan ang ating mga guro sa kanilang mga blended learning classes. Ang ating ETUlay ay mula kinder hanggang senior high school. Bukod sa academics, meron din tayong mga special programs gaya ng All is Wellness, Reading and Math Remediation, Storytelling, Mommy Tech Talks, Classes sa Gramatika, Speech Class, Financial Literacy, at marami pang iba. Pinalawig din ng ETUlay ang ating Alive Program para sa mga mag-aaral mula Grade 1 hanggang Grade 3. Gayun din ay mayroon tayong IELTS Program at SPED Tutorials na makasisigurong makakamit ng lahat ang inclusive education. May SPED hotline na rin para sa inyong mga katanungan patungkol sa special education. Kaya, subaybayan mula Lunes hanggang Biyernes, mula 9 ng umaga hanggang 7 ng gabi ang ating ETUlay. Sa ating pagtutulungan, maiaangat natin ang bawat isa. Ating itutulay ang pagkatuto upang di mapigil ang pag-aaral ng kabataang Pilipino. ETUlay natin ito, Sulong Edukalidad!
Calling all senior high school students. Let us all be super this second semester. Join your volunteer ETUlay tutors for science and technology subjects every Monday and be hashtag mahusay. Explore the incredible world of physical science with Tutor Lester and Tutor Nell, 4 o'clock to 4:40 p.m. Be internet smart and discover more about the different ICT tools that you can use on Empowerment Technologies together with Tutor Jane and Tutor Janelle, 4:40 to 5:20 p.m. Let Tutor Edson, Tutor Echo, and Tutor Leo guide you on how to be prepared for various hazards on disaster readiness and risk reduction, 4 o'clock to 4:40 p.m. And learn the concepts of genetics, biodiversity, anatomy and physiology, and evolution on General Biology 2 with Tutor Easter and Tutor Tina, 4:40 to 5:20 p.m. Be part of our team and be hashtag mahusay!
Mabuhay! Good day to all! I am your Tutor Madge. Welcome to ETUlay, a free online tutorial, an initiative of the Department of Education, Information and Communications Technology Service, Educational Technology Unit, ICTS EdTech. This program is aimed at helping and assisting learners from kindergarten, senior high school, ALS, Alive, and SPED learners. Aside from answering the modules, the ETUlay is offering programs which you will surely look forward to. Together with our parents and teachers, the ETUlay will bridge the gaps where difficulty and ease meet in learning new knowledge and skills. So, let us prepare our modules, pen and paper. Ready your mind to see and hear worthwhile and interesting lessons. Let us now study and learn together with our volunteer online tutors. Tara na!
Happy Monday afternoon, mga ka-ETUlay, sa ating mga viewers, bi-star students, teachers, at ating mga parents na nanonood this afternoon. So again, I am Tutor Tina from San Lorenzo Ruiz Senior High School, SDO Pasig. Hello, Tutor Easter!
Hello, Tutor Tina. Magandang buhay, mga ka-ETUlay at mga bi-star students. Magandang buhay din sa ating mga partner institution at mga ka-partner din ng mga guro ngayon sa ating episode. Ako si Tutor Easter ng Horacio de la Costa High School from SDO Caloocan City.
Yan. Okay, so today is April 25, 2022. And then we are celebrating last week, no, April 22, 2022, ang ating Earth Day. Ayan. So with the theme, Youth Invest in Our Planet. So we are encouraging all our kabataan, no, para makiisa para sa alagaan ang ating planeta, ang ating planet Earth. So sa maliliit man yan na paraan, pwede tayong makatulong para pangalagaan ng ating kalikasan. Yan. So sinelebrate natin yan last Friday.
Yes, Tutor Tina, talagang sinelebrate natin ang Happy Earth Day. Yan. So mga bi-star students, ano ang gagawin po natin ngayon? So before we start, let us prepare our pen and paper. Listen and participate actively.
Okay.
Respect one another and let's learn together. Are you ready, bi-star students? Tutor Tina, for our attendance check.
Okay, para sa ating attendance check, type in our comment section your name, your grade and section. Of course, i-shout out niyo rin ang inyong school. And kung mahaba yan, just type your location and also shout out niyo rin ang inyong General Biology 2 teacher. And don't forget to share this ang ating live sa Facebook. And of course, huwag kalimutan, no, na maging respectful sa ating mga comments. Ayan.
Okay, Tutor Tina. So sino ba ang ating mga bi-star students of the week 1? So ito po ang ating mga bi-star students: Daishi Vallejo, Kier Cantero, Elena Remorosa, Almarie Macarayo, Mary Anting, Clarence M. Conopio, Girly Casana, Michael Jake Lutiva, Casey Tive, Ivan De Lunas, James G. Red De Hio, Angelica Getiayon, Elia Cargente, Josh Melia, Leilani Jane Prego.
And also Tutor si Christine Cabalpin.
Ito naman ang bio-active school of the week natin, di ba?
Okay, congratulations sa ating mga bi-star students. Para naman sa ating bio-active school of the week, para sa ating quarter 4 week 1, we have Novaliches High School. Hi, hello po, good afternoon kay Ma'am Jeanette Tamse. We have also Horacio de la Costa Senior High School from our very own Tutor Easter. We have Lorenzo S. Sarmiento Senior National High School, Ma'am Noraida A. Sally. And then we also have Padre Garcia National High School. Hello po, Ma'am Ladeline Ducay. We also have Jones Rural School, Ma'am Cheryl Gompal Reyes. And ito masisipag tong mga student natin dito, Daniel R. Aguinaldo National High School, Ma'am Jen Melendres Pepito. And we also have
Okay.
So, yan. So I think we have Sir Jerwin and Sir Noli Balbin, and we also have the San Lorenzo Ruiz Senior High School para sa ating partner school for quarter four week 1. Ayan, thank you so much and congratulations po. Sana i-support nyo pa rin po ito until the end of the quarter. Okay, so let's have our recap, Tutor Easter.
Okay, congratulations sa ating mga partner schools and partner institution po and partner teachers po. So for our recap, so last week we have discussed about reproduction and development. So we have 3 questions here by a star student. So for every questions, let's guess the word that is being described by the sentences. So an unsuccessful reproduction where the parent's body breaks into pieces and each pieces grows into new individual. Bi-star students, what is this word?
Okay, so type 1, number 1. And then, ito may binigay na clue sa atin si Tutor Easter. Very witty. Okay, so ano kaya ang answer sa number 1?
May sagot na ba sila, Tutor Tina?
Okay, ayan, tingnan natin kung may sumasagot na. Is it fragmentation, Tutor Easter?
So, the word is fragmentation. Wow, very good ang mga biostar students natin, Tutor Tina, no?
Okay.
Second question, a hormone that stimulates the release of these two hormones, luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone, which help the ovarian and testicular function. What are this hormone all about? What is this word?
So type number 2 and then your answer. So ayan, basahin nyo lang and then ito ang binigay na hint sa atin ni Tutor Easter. Ano kaya itong hormone? Alright, so from Mary Anting, she answered gonadotropin. Okay, correct ba?
So what is this word, Tutor Tina? Correct, that is gonadotropin. So number 3 question, a process by which a sperm and an egg cell combine forming diploid zygotes. What is this process?
Okay, so type number 3 and then your answer. So tingnan natin yung binigay ni Tutor Easter. What do you call this process?
I think we have an answer already.
Yes, from Josh Melia. He answered number 3, fertilization. Okay, Bianca Nicole also answered fertilization.
Okay, very good sila, Tutor Tina. So the answer is fertilization. So for this week, what is our most essential learning competencies, Tutor Tina?
Okay, so for quarter 4, week 2, compare and contrast the following processes in plants and animals. So for this week, again, nasa organismal biology pa rin tayo. And then we're going to discuss nutrition, procurement, and processing for this week.
Okay. So last week, we have discussed about reproduction. Now we are going to discuss about nutrition. So nutrition is the process wherein the nutrients are being used by our body to have our different life processes in our body. So these nutrients help in the living organisms develop their bodies, grow, heal damaged body parts, and give energy for life and activity. And as you all know, we have different kinds of nutrients. And those three nutrients that gives our body to develop are our proteins to grow and heal our damaged body parts. And our nutrients that gives energy for life and activity are your carbohydrates, which is the main source of energy, and your secondary source of energy, which are your fats. So we have two modes of nutrition for our different organismal. Okay, so we have this autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. So when we say autotrophic nutrition, from the word auto, meaning they can produce their own food, biostar students. And when we talk about heterotrophic nutrition, the organisms cannot produce their own food. They depend on each other. They depend on others to have their own food. So we talk about first the heterotrophic nutrition. So heterotrophic nutrition undergo the process of digestion. So what is digestion then, Tutor Tina? Digestion is the mechanical and chemical process by which complex food substances are broken down into simpler substances. So when we say mechanical, these are the physical breaking down of foods. While when we say chemical processes, these are chemicals that we use to break down this food into simpler substances. So there are different parts of the digestive system. So una-una, mga biostar students, are syempre papasok ang ating food sa ating mouth.
Wow.
Okay? Opo. So, papasok ang food natin sa ating mouth, di ba? So, ito ay tinatawag natin na grinding and chewing of foods. So, by Tutor Tina, we have this different kinds, different parts of the mouth that helps in the facilitation in the mechanical process of the food. Di ba po, Tutor Tina? Ito po yung ating mga teeth, di ba?
The set of teeth.
Opo, di ba? So, meron tayong mga 32 teeth. Pero dahil ito ay ang wisdom tooth natin ay unti-unting nawawala, the average human teeth has 28 teeth. And also that age in the engulfing of the food is the mouth or the tongue that pushes the food through the esophagus. So the initial digestion takes place in the mouth, wherein the mouth produces the saliva that is produced by your salivary gland. So this saliva contains an enzyme, and these enzymes is called salivary amylase. So these salivary amylase are the ones that that breaks down the initial breaking down of starch in the food that we eat. And this food becomes a bolus. Medyo soften na siya, Tutor Tina. Kaya ito ay kayang-kaya na siyang i-push ng konti sa esophagus natin. So this esophagus is a muscular tube that facilitates the transfer of food from the mouth to the stomach. So this is our stomach, which is a muscular sac also. And this contains your gastric juices. And these gastric juices facilitate in the chemical breaking down of foods such as your proteins, fats, and carbohydrates. And together with the stomach, from the stomach, the food will now go to our small intestine, okay, for the final digestion. However, Tutor Tina, meron tayong mga accessory organs ng digestive system. Ano nga po ba yun ang mga accessory organs natin? These are your liver, pancreas, and your gallbladder. So the liver produces the bile. So ano bang ginagawa nun, Tutor Tina, yung bile natin? It aids in the digestion of fat. Opo. And the bile is being stored. Since the liver is the one manufacturing the bile, now this will be stored in the gallbladder for future purposes. So when there is a food already in the small intestine and it necessitates the breaking down of fats, the gallbladder will release this bile. And together with the gallbladder and the liver, the pancreas now will also act in the small intestine. So this produces pancreatic juices and enzymes that aids in the digestion of the protein and starch. So meron tong nire-release, Tutor Tina, yung mga pancreas natin na mga enzyme such as your pancreatic lipase para ano po natin yung ating fats po, pancreatic amylase to digest also, to break down the proteins and the starch. So together with this, gallbladder, pancreas, and liver, they will act on the small intestine. So the small intestine is a tube that contains the villi. So bakit ba sila may villi, Tutor Tina? Because this villi is the one responsible for the absorption of the nutrients and the water that is coming from the food. So this absorption of the nutrients will be the one that our body uses in order for us to function properly. So yan po yan sa small intestine. And now the food which has a waste products, okay? So may mga waste products siya, Tutor Tina. So the waste products are being transferred to the large intestine. So those nutrients that is needed by our body is absorbed in the small intestine, on the villi of the small intestine, while the waste products or the byproducts of the small intestine of the digestion, which is not needed in our body, will be transported in the large intestine. Okay? So this gets rid of any waste products. So meron tayo ascending colon, descending colon, and transverse colon. So this large intestine determines what kind of feces are we going to produce or are we going to excrete from the anus. Okay? So the anus is the opening that eliminates feces inside the body. And the end part of the anus is called the rectum. Okay? Apo yun, Tutor Tina. At dun sa ating, kung makikita mo, Tutor Tina, di ba? Dun sa ating rectum ay may tinatawag tayong rectal sphincter. So these rectal sphincter are the ones that prevents us from accidentally passing the feces na hindi po natin alam na napapasa natin. Kaya meron tayong control in passing out this feces in our body. Okay? So, meron tayong mga different digestive processes, Tutor Tina. So, as we have discussed, yung mga diniscuss natin mga parts, meron tayong mga different digestive processes. So, the first part is the ingestion. So, the ingestion is the process of taking in of food materials. So, this happens inside our mouth. And next process is digestion, which breaks down of food into smaller pieces. So, there are two digestion that takes place in our body. It is in our mouth and also in our, the final digestion, which happens in your small intestine. And then, the another digestive process is called absorption. So the absorption is the movement of nutrients, water, and electrolytes from the small intestine into the cell, then into the blood for the use of our body. And now, the last digestive process is called elimination. So these undigested materials are passed out of the system. Sabi nga natin, into the large intestine, then to the rectum and the, ano po, in the form of your feces. So, this is a summary of the human digestive system. So, first, it will go to the mouth to break down the food. Then, the food will go to the esophagus to connect the mouth to the stomach. And then it will go to the stomach, wherein gastric juices breaks the food chemically. And then the liver will break down the fats to the release of your bile. And then the gallbladder will store the bile. And the pancreas will aid also in the digestion of protein and starch in the small intestine, wherein the absorption of nutrients happen. And the waste products or the undigested food will go to the large intestine for the reabsorption of water and the excretion of the undigested materials. And then the last will be the anus, wherein it eliminates feces via the rectum. So there are feeding mechanism of animals, Tutor Tina. So merong mga different mechanism ang mga animals natin. So one is substrate feeders. So when we tell about substrate feeders, these are animals that live on the source of their food and eat through it. So naninirahan sila. Ito yung mga organism na naninirahan dun sa kanilang kinakain din. So common na common dyan ay ang tinatawag natin grasshopper. Di ba po mga biostar student, ang mga grasshopper po natin ay naninirahan sa mga leaves, sa mga stems, and then they also eat these leaves. So they are called substrate feeders. Another kind of feeding mechanism of animals is your filter feeders. So these are aquatic animals that strain the food particles from the water. So they feed themselves through the food particles that are found in the water. So example of that are the aquatic animals such as fishes, whales, and other aquatic animals. Another one is the fluid feeders. So fluid feeders are kind of animals that suck fluid that contains nutrients from another animals. So they live in order, they suck the fluid in order to live. So example of that is the mosquito. Okay? So they grow because of the blood that is being sucked by them. And another one is the bug feeders, wherein animals break down and swallow large amount of food. So example of that are the cats, yan, the mamas, yun po yung atin, and also just like us. Okay, so so there are different animal nutrients that we are that our body or animals
require.
Nutrients. Opo, tutor Tina. So, ito yung mga essential nutrients natin na kailangan po natin. So, meron tayong required nutrients. Bakit sila required, tutor Tina? Kasi ito ang kailangan sa natin sa mga different or major processes in the body. And diba, tutor Tina, they are called the macromolecules. Diba? So, yan po yun. So, these are your carbohydrates. Tuto, mga biostar students, ano nga po ba yung carbohydrates natin? Diba po, ito po ay number one or the prime source of energy. And also the fats, wherein it is the secondary source of energy. And ito rin, Tutor Tina, ang ginagamit natin kung bakit tayo hindi lumalamig kapag malamig ang panahon. Yung na-maintain natin yung body temperature.
Because it's insulator of fat, ang insulator of heat ang ating mga fats. And of course, sa carbohydrates, no, tutor Easter, syempre, ano tayo eh, ang pinaka-staple food natin talaga, rice. Kanin is life.
Kanin rice. Diba, mga Pilipino, daming energy. Yes. Kasi we love to eat rice, diba, tutor Tina? And also, syempre, yung pinakamaraming, ano, kailangan natin sa body kasi everything of us contains this kind of nutrients, which is the proteins, di ba?
Yes.
All of the things that we see in our body are made up of proteins because they are made up, the proteins are the ones responsible for the structural component of our body. Di ba, Tutor Tina?
Yes, ang ating mga hormones, enzymes, collagen, okay, all of those are proteins, no? Kaya napaka-importante.
Opo. At meron din tayong tinatawag na essential nutrients. So, ito naman ay kailangan natin din para sa mga ibang proseso ng ating katawan. So, ito yung amino acids natin, Tutor Tina, ay para naman sa ating mga, ano po, yun, di ba, yung nucleic acids, different nucleic acids for DNA, and so on and so forth. And the fatty acids, which is also the polymer of the fats, di ba, for energy source also. And for the regulation of our different body processes, andyan na yung mga vitamins and minerals natin. So, meron tayong mga fat-soluble vitamins and water-soluble vitamins. Diba po, Tutor Tina?
Okay. So, yung amino acids natin, Tutor Easter, no, yan yung ating building blocks of protein. So, meron tayong mga non-essential and essential amino acids. Yan na na-discuss na natin yan previously in our biology 1.
Yes, opo, tama, Tutor Tina. So we go now with the plant nutrition. Doon naman tayo sa mga autotrophic nutrition natin. So as we all know, when we have discussed in the Biology 1, di ba, Tutor Tina, the plant can manufacture their own food. And the process of manufacturing their own food is called photosynthesis. Tama po ba, Tutor Tina? Photosynthesis yun, di ba po? Yan, tama po. Di ba mga biostar student, tama po ba? The process of whereby our plants make their own food is called photosynthesis. Say yes nga po, mga biostar students. Thumbs up nga po. Kung naalala pa ang pinag-aralan natin sa ating Biology 1. Yan. So, in photosynthesis,
Yes, sabi ni Miko Jake. Si Russell also. Opo.
Yan. So, tama-tama, natatandaan talaga nila, Tutor Tina, no? Ang kanilang pinag-aralan sa Biology 1. So, in photosynthesis, there is the conversion of light energy to chemical energy in order for the plant to make their own food. So, in the products of your photosynthesis are your oxygen and your sugar in the form of your C6H12O6 plus 6O2. So, yan ang products sa ating photosynthesis. So the plant parts that involve in photosynthesis are your roots that absorbs and transport water and nutrients from the soil to the rest of the plant. And the leaves, that is the main part of photosynthesis, kasi diyan diyan talaga nangyayari ang ating photosynthesis. Our leaves contains our chloroplast, and this chloroplast contains chlorophyll, and this chlorophyll traps the sunlight from the sun. And with this, there is now the exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide inside the stomata of the leaves. So this is the summary of the photosynthesis. So sabi natin kanina, mga BioStar students, the roots absorb the water and nutrients and bring it to the other parts of the plant. So remember your xylem and phloem, di ba po? So the xylem is the one that absorbs the parts of the plant that absorbs the transfer, the water and minerals coming from the roots to the leaves. And in the leaves, sabi nga natin, it contains your chloroplast, and the chloroplast contains your chlorophyll. And this chlorophyll traps the sunlight. And bakit ba kailangan ang ating sunlight to convert the chemical energy of carbon dioxide and this to convert this into oxygen. So the oxygen is given off into the air para mahinga ng ating mga animals, and the carbon dioxide is converted further into sugar, and the sugar is stored in the food as food in the plant. And also, di ba, Tutor Tina, itong mga starch natin, starch ng plants po ay talagang kinakain rin po ng mga animals or humans, di ba po, Tutor Tina?
Yes, ang ating amylose, yan ang stored form of starch ng ating plants.
Opo. So, yan po ang ating summary ng photosynthesis. So, there are feeding mechanism. Kung kanina may animal feeding mechanism tayo, ngayon, meron din tayong feeding mechanism of carnivorous plant. So, meron tayong mga trapping mechanism. So, these are insect-eating plants that capture and digest their prey through pitfalls and traps. So, just like the example in the picture, wherein the insects are being trapped inside the leaves or the prey of the plant po natin. So, yan po. Oh. And another kind of example of the carnivorous plant is your picture plant. So, itong picture plant natin, makikita natin po sa Mindanao, that gives a sweet odor to make their prey fall into the picture. So, magbibigay sila ng mag-emit sila ng sweet odor. At
ito attract.
Opo. Nag-ina-attract nila, Tutor Tina, yung mga insects. At pag ito ay na-attract, syempre pupunta siya dun sa hole ng picture, di ba? Sa butos ng picture. And that will be their food. Another one is the Venus flytrap. So, this Venus flytrap closes down and traps their prey when touched. So, pag tinatch mo yan, meron silang, mag-o-open sila. Tapos, mag-close sila kapag na-touch mo sila. Okay, so yan po yung Venus flytrap. So ito po yung common sa ating Pilipinas na pinapalago natin. So nakikita po yan all over the Philippines. At Tutor Tina, mabilis lang padamihin at alagaan ng Venus flytrap. And this one is a cobra lily. So ito namang cobra lily naman, para makakuha siya ng pagkain, ay they confuses their prey. Paano nila kinoconfuse? Nagiging translucent window siya ng leaf. So hindi siya nakikita na parang kakain. Parang leaf lang siya, Tutor Tina. Kaya parang lily lang. Kaya hindi makikita siya ng mga insects or ng mga prey nila. Okay, next will be the yellow pitcher plant. So, the yellow pitcher plant collects rainwater to attract their prey. So, meron silang mga rainwater, Tutor Tina. So, pag umuulan, they collect this rainwater And this rainwater helps in the traction of their prey para makapunta dun sa loob ng kanilang kanilang part. And this is the sand dune that traps its prey using its sticky substance found in their in their leaves. So yung sticky substance na yon, once na pumunta po yung animals doon, hindi na po sila na makakaalis. Kaya yun ay unti-unti nang kakainin ng sand dune. And this one is the monkey cup. The monkey cup is that one that example of that is this monkey cup is also like a pitcher plant. Okay? So this is the one that traps and feed on their prey inside their cups also. So this this carnivorous plants are a very exotic plants. So meron nakikita sila pero talagang mamahalin sila kasi very exotic opo. Talagang gusto lang for decorative purposes yung tortina.
Collections mo, talaga.
Pero mo yung tortina, ang isang nila is $10 to $1,500. O diba, tortina, ang galing. Yan. So, diba, tortina, meron tayong animal nutrition. Siyempre, ang plant ay may plant nutrition din. Meron din siya mga plant nutrients na kinakailangan. So, as you can observe, meron silang mga macronutrients and micronutrients. So, tortina, nakita naman natin, diba, sa plant nutrition, more on, minerals, diba? So, mga minerals sila na kailangan. Bakit? Kasi these are the minerals that are necessary for the growing of the plants. And also, ito rin yung minerals na nakukuha nila in the soil. So, yan po. So, we go now with the knowledge share.
Ayan. Okay. So, yung macronutrients natin, yung NPK, no, Tutor Easter, na nakita natin usually sa ating mga fertilizers, nitrogen, potassium, and phosphorus. Okay. So, let's have now our knowledge check, mga BioStar students.
Okay. So, knowledge check tayo, Tutor Tina. BioStar students, ready na po ba kayo? Okay po ba? Type yes, okay. BioStar students.
Okay, so pakita na natin ang ating number one question, Tutor Easter.
A vulture ate a dead rat from the ground. What is the feeding mechanism shown in the scenario? A, bug feeder. B, fluid feeder. C, filter feeder. D, substrate feeder. BioStar students, type 1 and then the letter of your answer.
Okay, may mga sumasagot na. Okay, so from Christine Mantos, they are answering letter A, most of them, ng ating mga BioStar students. Is it letter A, Tutor Easter?
Tama, Tutor Tina. They are bug feeder. Okay? So, tinay nyo, Tutor Tina, di ba, dead rat. So, malaki ang rat na yan na kinain ng vulture. Kaya bug feeder siya.
Number two. The small intestine gets all the nutrients from the food we eat. This process is known as letter A, ingestion, B, digestion, C, absorption, or letter D, elimination. Okay, so type your answer number 2 and then the letter of your answer. Okay, Elena Romarosa answered letter C. John Wayne, letter C. Okay, is it letter C, Tutor Easter?
Tama, Tutor Tina. Okay. Ang gagaling ng mga BioStar students natin, that is absorption. Okay,
sabi
okay,
na number natin, three.
Tutor Tina, ang small intestine ay mga may bilay to absorb the nutrients. Number three.
What are the main products of photosynthesis? Is it A, sugar and oxygen? B, water and oxygen? C, sugar and carbon dioxide? Or letter D, water and carbon dioxide? Okay, so type number three and then your answer. Ano ba ang main products natin, no, ng photosynthesis? So most of them answered letter A. Is it letter A, Tutor Easter?
Tama, Tutor Tina. Sugar and oxygen. So we are talking about main products of photosynthesis because there are also other products of photosynthesis such as your water.
Okay, number four, a bodybuilder who exercises every day used to eat kilos of meat in order to maintain his body. Which part of his or her digestive system is responsible for protein absorption? Is it letter A, liver, B, stomach, C, pancreas, and D, gallbladder? Okay, so type your answer, number, and then the letter of your answer. Ayan, so anong organ kaya yan? Mary Ann answered letter C. Okay, so most of them answered letter C. Okay, very good.
So number five.
Okay, photosynthesis shows what mode of nutrition? A, symbiotic, B, autotrophic, C, saprophytic, or letter D, heterotrophic? Okay, so the answer, most of them answered letter B. Okay, is it letter B?
Okay, letter B, Tutor Tina. Ayan, autotrophic. So, very good ang ating mga biostar students, Tutor Tina. Nakinig talaga sila. So, we go now with the sci-fact of the week. A person can survive for 3 days without water and a month without food. So, we need our water in order for us to survive. Kung wala talagang makakain, Tutor Tina, talagang kailangan may water ka para makapag-survive ka sa ano po, sa desert island, di ba? Yun po.
Kasi during time of scarcity noon, basta may tubig.
Po. Kasi 60% of our body is water. For the mahusay
output. Okay. So for the mahusay output of the week, out of 31 BioStar students na nag-submit, okay, so ito yung mga napili namin na sumagot ng tama, okay, kasi yung iba, kinumpare nila yung plant and animal but not the reproduction, okay. So we have Justin Joy Clarion from Horacio de la Costa High School. And we also have Ayla Golosinda, again from Horacio de la Costa High School. Dashi Valeo from San Lorenzo Ruiz Senior High School. And then we have Jason Troy Lareza from Lorenzo S. Sarmiento Senior National High School. We have Christopher Pilapil from, again, Lorenzo S. Sarmiento Senior National High School. Okay. And then we also have Hani D. Enesito from Lorenzo S. Sarmiento Senior National High School, and Amar Sally. Okay, so dinescribe na, kinumpare nila yung proximity. So, and then also the fertilization and the development of plants and animals. Ayan, so we also have Arisa Abrenica from Horacio de la Costa High School, Nelson Colopong from Lorenzo S. Sarmiento Senior National High School. Okay, and then we have from Daniel R. Aguinaldo National High School, Christine M. Mantos. I think we have from Alan Mark De Jesus, ayan, from Naga City Science High School. Okay, so congratulations, BioStar students, and thank you sa pagsasubmit at paggawa ng inyong output. So for week 2, yan, so you have to make ang ating bio task for the week, make a 1 to 2 minute vlog, okay, magiging vlogger tayo for this week about the importance of nutrition to our bodies amid of the COVID-19 pandemic. Okay, so you need to submit that in our official Facebook page, ETUlay General Biology 2 with Tutor Easter and Tutor Tina until April 29 only. Ayan, so in vlogger ang ating mga BioStar students.
So, sayang ni Tutor, ang lahat ng bagay ay nag-uumpisa sa maliit. Alagaan mo ito at pag-emanin upang sa ganon ay maabot mo rin ang iyong minimiti, hashtag tagumpay. So, tulad din ating mga kinakain, nag-uumpisa sila sa maliit at dahil ito ay ating kinakain, ay ginagamit po natin ito para para ang ating katawan ay maging malakas, maging malaki, at maging matalino. So, hashtag tagumpay. Diba, ginagamit din sa atin sa ating mga pag-abot sa pangarap.
From simple to complex ang ating digestion. For our references po, we use the following books and modules and of course ang ating online references. Okay, so, and also don't forget to support other team mahusay senior high school science and technology subjects. We have physical science. We also have empowerment technologies, DRRR, disaster readiness and risk reduction, and of course, our general biology team.
So your feedback matters to us. We openly welcome your feedback, comments, complaints, suggestions, and concerns about what we are doing well and what you think that we could do better. So scan lang po yung QR code at i-type lang po yung link po na nasa ibaba.
Okay.
So thank you po. Up next, ano po natin, supportahan po natin ang us.
Okay, so again, this has been Tutor Tina. Thank you rin sa ating mga BioStar students. And thank you din. And then next week, see you again. Same time, Monday, 4:40 to 5:20 p.m. Okay.
Salamat din po sa aking partner na Tutor Tina at salamat sa ating mga BioStar students, partner schools at partner teachers. Asahan po namin ulit kayo na makita tuwing Monday 4:40 to 5:20 p.m. Again, ito po si Tutor Easter from Horacio de la Costa High School, SDO Caloocan City. God bless.
And bye-bye and see you next week.
See you next week.
Ang husay naman, natapos mo ang iyong tutorial session kasama ang iyong mahusay na ETUlay tutor. May bago ka bang natutuhan? I-share na yan gamit ang hashtag ETUlay Level Up. Huwag aalis ha dahil may susunod pang programa na pwede mo ring panoorin at salihan dahil naghihintay na ang iyong mga tutors. Happy learning dito sa ETUlay!